Thousands of NRM supporters have gathered at Kololo Independence Grounds to celebrate and thank President Museveni for his leadership and for spearheading the country since 1986. Some of the members at the event were dignitaries from different countries, political leaders, religious leaders, and other members of the public. The event was organized by the NRM Secretariat, led by the Director for Mobilization, Rosemary Seninde.
Through years of hard work and sheer resilience, you've given us hope and immense brilliance. Your love for Uganda has made dreams come true.
Amid ululations and praises from the crowds, President Museveni and the First Lady Janet Museveni arrived at the venue in the afternoon drizzle. In her remarks, the First Lady linked President Museveni to biblical Moses, who led the children of Israel from captivity. She added that God has used President Museveni to accomplish much for Uganda.
And he chose Yoweri Museveni, as he chose Moses, to lead the children of Israel from Israel. The President has told you on many occasions how people who knew him at that time called him a vagabond.
In his speech, President Museveni acknowledged the contributions made by many patriots and revolutionaries who have supported him in steering the country forward.
But NRM line is the line of the masses, the mass line. Abatasoma n'abasoma.
The president highlighted that service delivery is among the priorities that NRM set to transform the lives of many Ugandans. The president showcased the remarkable achievements over the years of his leadership. He, however, urged those who have not embraced the wealth creation programs to do so to get rid of poverty.
I got a delegation from Kagame, from the bureau, and they were saying our children are not getting jobs because they don't have money to buy jobs. Those to buy
Museveni also highlighted some prevailing challenges, among which are corruption and land grabbing, among others. He urged all Ugandans, starting from the local level, to tackle corruption head on. The president was awarded various gifts by various groups across the country in appreciation of his good leadership. The Minister of Internal Affairs, Major General Retired Kahindo Tafide, has urged police officers always to consider upgrading their qualifications. He said this increases their chances of promotions to higher ranks for police officers, as well as helping them to counter operational challenges. Otafide was speaking during the pass out of police officers after completing their training at Cavalier Police Training School.
You must strive to be better than Ndugabasi Miakagawa. I'm told you have degrees. Those of you who don't have degrees, get them. Because how can you be an officer when your colleagues have degrees and you have nothing?
Minister Tafiri added that the government is working to improve the welfare of police officers across the country. The Inspector General of Police, Abbas Biakagaba, has implored police officers to serve wholeheartedly and lead by example in their commitment to fighting corruption.
Embrace your mandate and powers to fight corruption is one of the evils that we must fight.
Among the 261 officers who were passed out at the rank of Assistant Inspector of Police, 215 were male and 46 were female. Britain's head of state, King Charles III, officially appointed Labour leader Keir Starmer as Prime Minister on Friday during an audience at Buckingham Palace. Keir Starmer, the 61-year-old leader of the Labour Party, will now become the third Prime Minister in 2 years after Charles tasked him with forming a new government during a meeting at Buckingham Palace.
I have just returned from Buckingham Palace, where I accepted an invitation from His Majesty the King to form the next government of this great nation.
As a constitutional monarch, Charles is not supposed to express any political opinion in public and does not vote. Experts have suggested Charles has some ideological affinity with Starmer, a one-time anti-monarchist, and will likely greet his arrival with some relief, hoping can restore political stability. The outgoing Prime Minister, Rishi Sunak, resigned today after the Conservative Party's crushing defeat in the general election.
I will shortly be seeing His Majesty the King to offer my resignation as Prime Minister. To the country, I would like to say first and foremost, I am sorry. I have given this job my all, but you have sent a clear signal that the government of the United Kingdom must change, and yours is the only judgment that matters. I have heard your anger, your disappointment, and I take responsibility for this loss.
Professor Ed Owens, a specialist in the monarch, say the King had long expressed concern around key social issues, including poverty, issues around the food crisis in the UK, homelessness, and concerns around young people's education and opportunities. Starmer, with whom the monarch will have a private weekly meeting, has demonstrated a key interest in these areas and has promised to work for all equitability.
We will carry the responsibility of your trust as we rebuild our country. But whether you voted Labour or not, in fact, especially if you did not, I say to you directly, my government will serve you. Politics can be a force for good.
The EU has congratulated Keir Starmer on Labour's election win in Britain, with Brussels foreseeing warmer ties with London, though little scope to change existing post-Brexit arrangements. Britain's new Prime Minister has vowed to reduce trade frictions with the European Union, forge closer security arrangements and relax travel restrictions for touring musicians. But Starmer is also adamant his government will never reverse Brexit nor seek to be part of the European single market.